respondent leaders from the catechetical ministry. So as you could see from that, we got the most from Manila, 79, Capiz, 50, and then there's still some provinces which have zero responses. And then most of them identified themselves as full-time coordinators, about 50% of them. And then still, as with the catechists, most of our catechetical leaders are female, being almost 90% of them, of those who responded. And they are still married, and they are lay. This is based on those who responded to our survey. Well, they have a clear understanding of their job as a catechetical leader. 96% of them said yes. And almost the same, 93%, says that they have an organizational structure in their catechetical ministry. Their mission vision is well disseminated in their diocese and parish as a catechetical ministry. So from here, you could see that the catechetical ministry is being led well. There's the structure, there's the mission vision. They also have a curriculum, though lower, 87% of them. And their primary objective is the outline provided by the Catechism for Filipino Catholics or the Catechism of the Catholic Church, 84% of them. And then the top three materials used in preparing their syllabus are the Bible, CFC, and CCC. And most of them believe that formal catechetical formation is important, 94%, but then for those who receive, it becomes lower. Only 82% of them receive formal catechetical formation. And then if yes, what form? About half of them only receive a certificate in catechetical ministry or religious education. And then does ECHE organize conduct ongoing formation for the catechetical leaders? Only 62% of them said yes. That ECHE provides. Then, when asked on how do they deal with their catechists, they conduct their regular consultation meetings regarding the concerns of the catechists. Monthly, 64% of them reported that. And then, they also evaluate their catechists, which is done on an annually. And then, still, like with their catechists, they are also happy, satisfied, and just like the catechist, they also have other roles and services. And then they know the issues that the catechists are faced with, and their family supports them in their catechetical ministry as well. Same with the catechist. And they are also committed in the catechetical ministry. So you could see there is some similarity with that of the catechist. They are still happy, satisfied, committed. Now, here are some word cloud analysis regarding the responses of the catechetical leaders. So here, when asked with a question, are you happy at the moment as a coordinator, director? Yes, because of the Lord, parish, church. If you could see that there's now a shift in the answers of why they are happy in the catechetical ministry compared to the catechist. Now, from the pupils, it now becomes to the parish, to the church. How satisfied are you as the director? Still, it's because of God, work, love. Here comes where the other roles and services of the catechetical directors. In the question on how do they manage their multi-roles in the ministry? They're also working in the parish, as a coordinator, religious, teaching. Hindi lang po sila catechetical director, multi-function po talaga sila. Their family supports their ministry, still relevant, happy, serve, mission, vocation. And then here are now some pastoral insights regarding the data that we have been able to gather. Doc?
Sabi ko mag-PhD na siya sa catechetical, sa religious education eh. Sabi kong gano'n. No? Thank you so much, my dear. Okay. So, you could just imagine how I train people, right? Yung sabi ko sa kanya, one day you will wake up, you're going to talk to the catechetical leader. Sabi, undergrad pa lang po ako. No! You process the data, so you have the right to say it, right? Anyway, now, let's look into the pastoral insight. Pagdasal niyo po, makakuha siya ng scholarship para makapag-aral po siya, no? ng ano, religious education. Kasi sayang naman yung exposure niya sa catechetical ministry, right? Anyway, pastoral insights, demographic. One, we think that we see catechetical leadership in the country as well most welcoming of women. No? Marami kayo na mga kababaihan. And I think it's an issue of inclusive faith, no? You are empowered through the catechetical ministry, and feminists will be happy with this one, right? Kasi parang, wow, talagang empowered ang women when it comes to catechetical leadership. Kasi, although you know that your parish priest is more likely the men, but no, the one that are really leading, yung pala, naduduguan ba sa lahat ng ginagawa sa katesismo, mga babae po ang na-discover natin. Leadership knowledge and roles. You have clear understanding of your job, okay? But the issue of multiple roles that you do is something that is fascinating to look at. Napansin niyo po doon sa word cloud kanina, which is very interesting, no? Look at this. Kanina, lector. Naintindihan niyo po ba? Yung catechist, lector. Yun ang ano niya, barangay. No? Wow, naalala niyo talaga, no? Kasi visual. Ladies and gentlemen, ang catechetical leaders, ito ang problema. Parish. So tama yung sinasabi ko kanina, di ba? Yung mga catechista, meron silang mga roles. Lector sila, meron sila sa barangay. Ang mga leaders, buong parokya. Siya na yung leader ng pastoral council, katekista pa siya, lahat na ng organisasyon. It is very interesting to notice. Kasi you coordinate, ikaw na eh, leader ka eh. Ngayon ko naintindihan na mas grabe ang problema ng head catechist. No? Pag sinabi kang head catechist ka, lagot ka. Pag sinabi coordinator ka sa buong diocese o ET, patay ka, right? Kasi ang bigat ng role mo, dahil alam mo, yung role mo bilang catechetical leader, it comes with lots of more other roles. And ang nakita namin sa field is that it's because you're expected to know all the rituals, all the sacraments, and all those things that you need to practice, kayong pupuntahan. Is that a sorry state? I don't think so. What we're arguing only is this. You just have to talk about your multiple roles because it's a reality. Meaning, we're not arguing na dapat isa lang. Hindi pwede kasi multifaceted ang mundo natin. You just have to talk about the multiple roles. So, there is an existing organizational structure. Maayos naman. May mission vision ng diocese na di-disseminate naman. However, it's an issue of how you implement your programs. How do you implement it? Sino mo maharang? Diba? Anong problema, right? Kasi wala nang problema. May vision na, may plano na. Yung pag-implement ang problema natin, right? Now, let's talk about leaders' research competence too, right? Research competence ng mga leaders. Kayo po. Research competence. Ibig sabihin, yung existing syllabus, may mga materials, pero issue siya ng leadership training when it comes to research competence. Kailangan nyo pong matuto mag-research. Kasi kayo pong expected to look into the modules, to look into a lot of things. If you do not have a research dimension, patay na kasi ibabagsak at ibabagsak nyo lang, hindi nyo kine-question, hindi kayo nagbabasa, and everything. Naku, malaking problema ito. Formation. So, okay naman. Meron namang formal training. Most of the directors reveal that ECHE conducts ongoing catechetical formation for them. So, it's an issue of continuous religious education and professionalization. And I would love to thank people for conducting this one. Kasi ito na yun. Yung ina-argue nito, eh ito na yun. Ang question ko is, nasan yung iba? Sociologist po ako eh. So I don't question what I see. I question what I do not see and what is strange in the familiar. My question is, there are more leaders than you. What's happening to them? Question to ng center periphery again. You have access going here. You know that it costs a lot, right? Now, how can you duplicate, replicate this kind of activity dun naman sa mga leaders nyo? doon sa periphery, right? Pastoral insights, leadership approaches. Nagko-consult naman po kayo, pwede naman, nagkakanda kayo assessment, you know certain issue, but is there such a thing as talking about how you manage catechetical ministry? I think it's important that there are things that you could manage from the theological point of view, pero human affairs is being managed, and there is a science of human affairs that you have to incorporate. It's not an issue of just you volunteering on it. You have to be able, as catechetical leaders, know how to manage people. Yun po ang medyo interesting na kailangan natin ng management approaches in terms of catechetical ministry. What about life and spirituality? You're happy, you're satisfied, you're committed, but again, just like the catechist, it's an issue of your well-being. It's an issue of how balanced your life is relative to other tasks that you do. Anong pwede natin pag-isipang programa tungkol doon? I don't know. But it's always an issue of well-being. So, that's about the catechetical leaders. Okay? So, there are more questions that we're going to raise later. But for now, I want you to be oriented to how beautiful a presentation would be if it's contextualized. And when I said contextualized, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina po na paano nangyayari na ang isang paper katulad nito ay i-compare mo sa isang ecclesiastical territory. Paano siya mag-iiba? Kaya nga ngayon, pagkatapos ng presentation na ito, magkakaroon po tayo ng ecclesiastical province workshop. Or whatever you want to call it. Basta mahalaga, bibigyan ko kayo ng... And then we will have some reporting. Dahil dito yon. Your data, the national data, will not mean anything if it will not be contextualized to a particular case. And I was telling you about my February presentation with Archbishop Utleg and the rest who called upon us to talk about what is the state of catechetical ministry in their province, sa Archdiocese of Tumikara. And so this is our research story. We examine the empirical findings, compare it, taking the Archdiocese of Tumikara as a case in point. So we present the results to share the salient similar patterns and demonstrate variations. The conclusion will be, ito ang problema ng Tuguegarao. Ganun siya, right? No? Compared to national data. At least, hindi na siya kwento-kwento, hindi na chismis-chismis, right? No? Totoo to. Kasi meron kang pinagbasihan. So, our hope is that the comparative observations are utilized to understand pastoral interventions. So, ako excited ako kina Bishop Francis kasi taga Antipolo po ako eh. Nung palagi ako nandun, wala akong choice, doon ako sinilang, right? So, sa Antipolo, nung una, walang ano, walang responses ba? Kailangan ko tumawag kay ate, sabi ko, ate, kailangan ko tulong mo. Hindi kami nag-o-online. Kailangan namin ng papel, right? Oh, nung may papel na, natapos na lahat, right? Oh, wow, so we have about 500 from Antipolo. Excited ako kasi gusto kong gawin to sa kanila. To understand pastoral interventions that are critical to implementing more effective catechetical ministry. In this case, Tuligara. Let me share it with you now. Okay, this one. Look at the pattern. Okay? So, pareho lang siya. When it comes to... And we're talking only of 103 respondents compared to 1,600. Ah. So, talagang power mo. Pakikita mo, wow! Saan sila mag-iiba, right? O, pareho siya. Middle adult, female. So, whether national or Tuguegarao, pareho ang nangyayari. Wow, that's interesting. Next, married. Married naman. Pareho siya, pareho ng pattern, right? The yellow one is the Tugue, all is the orange one, okay? Buti na lang, meron sila sa Catholic Church. So, not a big issue. Okay? Sa mga researchers, hindi issue pag pareho. Issue pag nag-iiba, right? So, yun ang issue namin. Okay. Majority of the catechist respondents, as explained a bit later kanina, a while ago, college graduates. Pero sa Tuguegarao, 49.5% yan siya. Compared to the national, yung 103 mas educated ang mga nasa Tugue. Alam na, retired. Talagang retired na, alam mo yan. So yan, okay? Yan, exciting na, meron ng istorya. May istorya na, right? Layperson pa rin po, wala pong problema doon. Pero take note of the education, ha? Take note. Sa level ng national, okay lang. Medyo average na college educated. Pero sa ano, almost half of them. Okay? Almost half of them. Ito 21% lang eh, o a fifth lang eh. Ito 50%, that's something. Pag college educated ang minamanage mong mga, yan na. Pag college educated ang minamanage mong mga katikista, good luck. Good luck. Kasi meron siyang implication sa lahat ng bagay. At makikita mo yan. Okay, ito. Commonly done, again, it's public schools, Tugue, ganun pa rin, and 83%, yan, 83% public schools. So, dun pa rin, pareho pa rin. Pareho ng pattern. Pag pareho ng pattern, okay lang. Part-time sila, okay? Part-time. So, the same thing. Now, which group do they catechize? Pareho pa rin, elementary pupils. No, shared to ng buong bansa, no? Na pagkakatikista ka, dadong ka sa elementary. Wow, something that you have to think about, ha? Mamaya. Okay? Next. Involvement. Yung sharing nila. So, pareho. 47, 40, pareho. Talagang ang nakuha naming data ay yung nagtuturo ng 5 years. Okay? First 5 years. Ganun pa rin po, 1.5 hours per week ang inilalaan. Structurally limiting yan kasi yan talagang binibigay lang ng mga eskwelahan para magturo. Catechesis. Oh, this is something very interesting. Kasi, all 71 supportive family. Pero dito sa Tuguegarao, interestingly, parish priest ang bida sa kanila. Kaya nung nadun ako, nasa training ako ng mga pari, bang level ang saya ng mga pari, napapalakpakan, right? Oo. Kasi it was reported na ang first nila is ano, is parish priest, ang sumusuporta sa kanila. Right? This is the factor in doing making effectively difficult catechesis, right? Ngayon, it's shared na talagang passive indifferent students ang problema nila, saka passive and indifferent parents ang parents of students ang problema nila. Why their catechesis, they think that it's not effective. So, no big difference here. Difficult. So, sino ang influencers nila, right? Co-catechist sa national, co-catechist, shared siya, no? But it's interesting na tingnan niyo yung priest nila, oh. Yung nire-report nila, priests. There is a priest narrative amongst these 103 respondents. Something may nangyari sa kanila, I don't know. It's not a bishop narrative, it's a priest narrative, right? They are reporting that they're being supported and they're influenced by their priests. No? How I wish na ito yung nakita ko sa national data. Hindi yun. Nakita ko sa national data. Iba, okay. Iba. Okay. Factors doing catechesis effectively. Ayan. Sense of volunteerism, deep relationship with Jesus. Look at this one. This is for Tuguegarao, deep relationship with Jesus. Yung sa kanya. Okay? So overall, sense of volunteerism, national. Pero sa kanila, deep relationship with Jesus. Wow! Medyo interesting to, no? Ang assumption ko nung nakita ko yung datos na to, oh my God, I think these respondents are truly formed. Parang siguro talagang yung formation nila malalim. Di ba? Malalim formation siguro ng mga taga-Tuguegarao. Yun ang assumption ko. Difficult factors in doing effectively. Does your family support? Yes. May support talaga sila sa family nila. So, imagine nyo po 61% lang sa national, pero sa kanila talaga 99 out of every 10 respondents said, you know, supportado kami ng pamilya. Right? Namin. factor, priority ng catechist is to deepen relationship with Jesus. Ito na yung ano, okay? Deepen relationship with Jesus. So, yun yung kanyang lumalabas sa tugin. Now, do they receive compensation? Okay? Majority of the catechist respondents do not receive compensation. Except for Tugigaraw. Where majority receive compensation. Wow! Naiiba na! Naiba na ang landscape. Naiintindihan niyo po ba? Yung reading ko kanina, pero okay lang eh. Pero naiba na yung landscape kasi kino-compare ko na siya sa national. Ganun ka-powerful kung kainintindi nyo yung inyong data. Hindi nyo pwedeng sabihin na, alam mo mga katikista, sabi ni Yayet, ganito daw. Hindi, tingnan mo yung data mo, baka iba. Yun ang point ko po. Kaya pinagkapakahirapan kong explain to sa inyo. Kasi never get into concluding anything unless you have a proof. And you already have a data. Yun ang gagamitin nyo. Okay? Now, look at this. They reported na, yes, 50, almost half sa kanila ang compensated. Okay? Compensated. In what form, I think, compensation in the catechesis? Meron silang transportation, yung lahat, no? Pero may stipend sila. May stipend sila. Yun ang report nila eh. Stipend sila. And syempre, happy sila, di ba? Wow, may stipend itong mga ito, di ba? Wow, sana doon na lang ako sa tugi magkatikista, right? No? Parang ganun yung effect, right? No? Anyway, pero maganda siyang exercise, right? Maganda siyang exercise. Now, we get into a more solid issue now, right? So how those receiving compensation, receive monthly 29%. So, may transpo, pero meron talagang binabayaran sa kanila, right? Confirmed naman to ng mga taga-Tugen. So hindi naman to gawa-gawa lang. Oh. To confirm ko. Now, those receiving compensation, Catholics usually received 500. Yung pa rin ang inano, nire-report ko nila. Okay? Now, what do they prefer? Well, ang preferred receipt po ng compensation, transpo general. Pero ito, clothing allowance, transpo, tingnan nyo po sila, yung disposition po nila, regular salary. Something is going on, right? So, ibig sabihin, ibang, ano to, number of ano, ibang type of catechist, right? So, they are, for them, it's regular salary. Now, remember ha, there's nothing wrong with ano ha, with this one ha. It's only showing you the variations versus the national data. This one is the most exciting for me. Majority believe that catechetical formation is important. Mataas pa sa Tugigaraw, 68.9%. But we ask the question, did you have any formal catechetical formation? Majority of the catechist responses received national. Nakaka-receive tayo ng catechetical formation except for Tugigaraw. Why? Because 52% of them responded that they did not receive any catechetical formation. Interesting. Isn't that fascinating? Now, tell me, you need to look at it more. Ito yung sinasabi ko. So what's happening now with the data set ng Tugen? And I was talking to them. Meaning, this is what we got. This was reported. No, you have to ask. Meaning, bakit ito yung nireport nila? Did they not understand the question? Kasi majority of the entire Philippines is saying that they received catechetical form. Pero sila hindi. Okay? Any formal, formal. You have to understand formal. Yung formal, ito yung merong catechetical training, may certificate, 2 years and everything. And so probably we're dealing with those who are volunteers really. The retired teachers, for example. Do you expect them to have a formal catechetical training? No. They're all devoted to everything. They're already teachers, right? Diba? Formal catechetical formation. Catechist respondents usually have a certificate. Less. Okay? Yung overall. Tugigaraw, ito oh, 24% lang of them. Naintindihan niyo po? So it's starting to make sense. Ah, ito pala yung nangyayari. Rate the degree of importance. Siyempre naman, importante. Wala namang question doon. Napaka-importante nga, 83.5%. Diba? Now, on catechetical formation still, they believe that it is important. Tingnan niyo po, oh. Ang sabi ko sa kanila, these are hungry people wanting to be formed. Nag-iintay sila. Ito yung sinasabi ng data. Sabi nila, hindi sila formally trained. So, ongoing formation, they are so hungry. Talagang, yes, of course. We need that, right? Now, majority of the parishes offered programs. Okay? Parishes, nag-offer naman ng program, right? Ang tuge, medyo mababa. Okay? And then I started to realize the politics in the archdiocese. Kasi sabi ko, where do I get all this? Okay. It's all about the politics. Alam mo yon yung... Well, beyond na tong studying tong yun. Okay? So, they attend. Testing naman ito siya. Oh. Ito lang po siya. They attend ongoing. And then ito lang sinasabi sa Tugigaro, 56. Okay? Was, is this disheartening for them nung in-explain ko to? No. It's enlightening. Because they already know it. They told me. They need an affirmation that they need new programs for the catechetical ano daw nila. Kailangan nila ng bagong blood. Yun ang sabi ni Bishop, right? Okay, no. So, how often majority of the catechist respondents merong monthly catechetical formation? Majority, right? May monthly. Ang Tugigaraw, annually. Ito oh, annually siya. So, while generally sinasabi may monthly, at least sa national data, sa Tugigaraw, ang report nila, they only have annually. And then they told me something that rocked my world. Sabi nila, annually. Sabi nung mga data validation, annually? Ano kaya ibig sabihin ng annually? Sabi ko, yes, they reported annual, ongoing formation. Dok Yayet, may problema ka dyan. Bakit? Christmas party yan. Sabi ko, oh my God! I'm so sorry! Kasi, totoo ba? Sabi ko, naku Yayet, sinasabi ko sa'yo, yung annual na yan, hindi formation yan. Magsasama-sama yan para sa Christmas party. Kasi may gift. Sabi sa akin, kaya okay na may monthly kasi alam mo na, whoa! Pero pag may nagre-report na annually lang, party yan. Sabi ko, I'm sorry, I cannot report that kasi hindi ko naman what formation, right? But anyways, but it seems that it's true. It seems that it's true. Now, look at this one. Parish is the top provider. It's the same. The priest is the most helpful sa kanila. Oh my God, I love the priest narrative here. It's the most helpful according to them. Okay? Diba big time? Ano yun? Teka lang ha, wala pa po akong correlation na sinasabi. Sabi nila, meron kaya correlation yung allowance versus the ano? I don't know. Wala pa po akong correlation analysis na ginagawa. Okay, so anyway, eto po siya. Look at this one. Sacraments and liturgy po ang pinaka tinuturo po nila. So yun ang para sa kanila. Next, top 3 lesson planning ang para sa tuge versus tech teaching. It's beautiful to have comparisons kasi makikita mo kung anong preference po nila. Now, parehin naman how degree of helpfulness, very helpful, very much, parehin naman. Wala namang problema. So, dispositions nila on these questions, walang problema. Now, content, pareho lang when it comes to the provision, kung meron bang tinuturo, kung pinoprovide ang parish, and then most of the catechist respondents use the provided catechetical. So they follow. But, look at this. There's a difference, no? Ng pag-follow nila. So, something to look into to infer, okay? So, majority of the catechists consider the module research-based and everything, right? So, meron silang, group ng catechists itong nakikita natin sa Tugigaraw. Top 3, yan. Dito, catechism of the Catholic Church, pare lang naman. Okay? So, majority, Bisaya kasi Bisaya, mas marami, right? But syempre, gusto nila Ilocano and English. Okay? Sa Tugue. Right? Syempre, nasa taas yun. Nasa ano nila, right? So, when it comes to instruction, majority of the catechists prefer the use of Bisaya, syempre, no? Tugue, Ilocano. Ganda, no? So, at least makikita mo yung difference. Kasi, alam mo mali ang data mo kapag lumalabas ng gusto ng mga taga-Tugue raw, Bisaya. Naintindihan niyo po ba? Kung sakaling hindi yan ang lumabas, lagot tayo, di ba? Para imagine mo, dapat ang catechetical module sa Tugue raw, Bisaya. Ano ba? Di ba? May problema na tayo niyan. Invalid ang data. Ibig sabihin. Next. So, ito po yung familiarity with the content. Pareho po siya. Dukat, yukat. Naku, si Father Richard, kailangan ko kausapin. O, saka yung dukat natin. So, we have to push, no? Push more about the, you know, understanding of dukat and yukat. Strategies, storytelling pa rin. Ganun pa rin po yung storya. Okay? Now, majority of the catechists, lecture method ang least effective para sa lahat, katulad ng ginagawa ko. This is least effective. Manila paper, blackboard, yung pa rin. Wala namang pagkakaiba sa national and sa Tugue Garao case. Predominant issues, eto siya. Parents do not go to church. You have to make sure sa pastoral planning nyo ngayon, itong issue to na ni-report ng mga katikista at ng mga katikista na alam nila na ang issue na kinakaharap ng mga katikais ay hindi nagsisimba ang kanilang mga parents. It's a reported thing. Now, read the Bible. Okay, pareho po siya. When it comes to the receiving of the Holy Communion, medyo mataas talaga ang report nila dito sa Tugue. No, not Tugue. Tugue, you have catechists that really attends all this rituals. Medyo mataas po yung Marian and nila doon. Yun po yung na-discover po namin ako. Kaya pagdating po dito, mataas, di po ba? Annually, reconciliation annually, okay? Now, spiritual exercises, pareho lang po. Okay? Ganito rin sa when it comes to spiritual life, participation, pareho lang siya. Generally. Now, when it comes to religious practices, dalawa lang naman po yung shared natin, novena and via crucis, right? So, itong prayer of novena and other devotion to Blessed Mother, mas mataas talaga sa kanila. Iyon sinasabi ko na you cannot argue on something na wala kang basis. Meron talaga, mataas sila, even compared nationally sa Marian devotion nila. Now, majority of the catechists share the same disposition that their relationship with Jesus is as Lord. Okay? Not as friend, not as teacher, but as Lord. Okay, so this is very exciting kasi life is sacred, marriage is sacred, and lifetime commitment. Ito po yung dalawang pinakamahalagang lumalabas po. Okay? Belief. No? We could deal more on this later, but for me, you have to celebrate the fact that, you know what, our catechists reported that they believe that life is sacred and that marriage is sacred. That's good enough for me. Kasi pagkaiba yung sinabi, patay tayo niyan, right? No? Nang nagtuturo ng basic faith, may problema. Okay. What describes you? Okay, this is interesting. Happy, very happy, satisfied. But look at this. They are fully committed. Okay? They are fully committed. They reported that they are fully committed than the national day. Full commitment, no? Para yung sinasabi kanina ni Ma'am Cecil, na pag kinompare mo ang Cebu, sabi mo nga, sino kaya nag-ano dito sa Cebu? Kasi alam mo sa Cebu, na majority happy, sila very happy. Alam mo yun, yung sa Cebu, at least yun yung isa sa naran namin. So, wow, very happy yung mga taga Cebu. Sa amin, mahalaga yon. Kasi simple lang, pero wow, there's a big difference. Pastoral insights. Now, we're getting there now. Okay, then we will have about an hour of ano. Okay, now. This is how we see it. Catechists identify their supportive family and co-cat as the main influencer persons that encourage them to become a catechist and in doing catechesis, you know, teach catechesis effectively. Whereas, yan na, Archdiocese of Tagigarao identified their parish priest as main influencer person. That is something to think about, no? Ang tanong ko, bakit hindi ganun sa iba? Di ba? That's interesting. Nako, pagka may mga parish priest na hindi nakaka-influence, no? It's an issue. Additionally, their sense of volunteerism motivates them to become catechists. In contrast to Archdiocese Tagigarao, is deep relationship with Jesus. Okay ba siya? Okay? Yung general sense of volunteerism sa Tagigarao, malalim. Deep sense of deep relationship with Jesus. Now, compensation. Yan na. Okay, yan na. Majority of the catechists do not receive compensation, but to some who receive compensation at transportation allowance. Contrary, the Archdiocese of Tagigarao stated that most of them receive compensation in the form of transportation allowance and honorarium. Okay? Fact yun. Walang question dun, right? Moreover, in general, most of the catechists still prefer to receive their compensation through transportation allowance. Whereas, the Archdiocese of Tagigarao prefer their compensation in the form of regular salary aside from transportation allowance. This is very exciting. If you're the Archbishop, oh my! Diba? There are only 103. I think they are going to have more, right? Now, on formal catechetical formation, in general, majority of the catechists receive formal catechetical formation monthly. In contrast to the Archdiocese Tagigarao, that most of the catechists do not receive formal formation. But for some who have the catechetical formation, they only receive it annually. I'm sorry, that's my extension. I don't have proof to that, right? Pero, did you see the impact of comparing? Nakikita nyo na po, I hope you're seeing it na mahalaga na huwag nyong gamitin yung national data to characterize your catechist. No. I'm going to use the national data for the bishops. But you don't do it for you, baka mali ang sabihin nyo sa kanila kasi hindi pala yung characteristic nila. Okay? Next, on catechetical content, the catechists prefer the use of local regional languages. Clear yun. There's no question of that. Catechist spiritual life domain, in general, the catechist rated commitment, you know, to their being catechist. Pero, Archdiocese of Tagigarao stated they are fully committed. Pang level, no? Okay. So, based on the results obtained, we think that the parish priests in the Archdiocese of Tagigarao are very supportive to their catechists who are relatively compensated. Entindihan nyo? So, pwede ko sabihin, they are supported, pero paano sila sinusuportahan? Clear yung suporta sa kanila. And they reported it, right? But, the catechists have weak formal catechetical formation, directing attention on how teaching catechism is delivered to their students. A bit critical, but empowering. We receive feedback from the priest na who listened to us, na sabi, you know what, it is high time for us to do something for the catechetical ministry in Tagigarao. Which is good. Kasi sometimes data bites. Alam mo yun? It bites you to a certain degree na, oh my God, this is what's happening in my area. We have to do something about it, right? I hope you could see the urgency in your respective ecclesiastical territories. Okay? So, now is the time for us to have some kind of a workshop. Are you okay? Okay. I need a chair. I need a chair. Kasi I'm going to show them all the things that, Okay. Okay. Good. Thank you. Yeah. Let me sit kasi I'm going to click a lot of things to show you so that you will be excited with what we're going to do. Kasi I know you will not get excited if I will not show you things that I'm going to share with you, which you need to... Okay. Now, this is what is inside the 1.2 gig data. And I'm giving this not because I want you to have problems in the future. I just want you to know that we are really serious in sharing the data. But we're serious when you read it, please have some prudence. If you don't know it, ask. Okay? This is incomplete, but it will give you a feel. First that you need to know is that I'm sharing with you the literatures. An example of this is this one. Okay? This is a full book. Okay? Which you could read on the state of religious education noong 1979 pa, right? So lahat ito. Okay? If you want to know about Legazpi's work, I'm also sharing this to you. Right? So we can scan it so that you could have a copy of it, because it's very difficult for you to argue on something that you did not do and did you not read. Please do not argue on something that you do not know. Okay? So please, pag researcher ka, hindi ka pwede nag-argue na hindi mo alam. Dapat kailangan mo nagbasa ka, right? So wag tira ng tira, kasi napapasama yung pananampalataya natin. Na, okay? Pag hindi alam, parang ganun po. So that's the literature. I'm sharing with you all this, including Pope Francis Catechist Living the Faith, Veritatis Gaudium, which you could download, but we included it here. Para may reference po kayo lahat, okay? So I wanted you to be researchers now, okay? Next, I'm also sharing with you all the presentations we had, okay? And all the documentation workshop that we're going to use. But these are more important. Okay, yung module natin yan, binigay ko na rin sa inyo. Itong module na ito, pwede nyo naman gawin to pag kayo na yung magagawa. No? Meaning, ang hindi ko naintindihan, you do a lot of training, you don't develop your own module. Please, if you're, dapat may module kayo, dapat alam ko ano mangyayari, at alam yung expectation, may learning goals pa, and everything, right? If you are questioning why I am like this, I am a DepEd and CHED consultant. I have something to do with K-12. I was one of those who designed the K-12 thing. So I was subjected to pain and suffering for a number of years developing the policy standards and guidelines in the teaching of sociology in the country, and also the development of social science curriculum guides for K-12. And so talagang kailangan kung ano yung natutunan doon, i-apply, right? Outcomes-based and everything. So you will have your time for that. Now, let me excite you. This are the three things that you have to be excited about. First is what we call as the NCS demographics. We were not able to call everything, but at least we will give you an example. This is from the 17,000 respondents of our survey. There you go. Yes. May pangalan siya. Okay? So we are looking at 494 pages of the list of catechists who responded here. Okay? Okay? And so there is another... Patay na daw yung iba nito. Oo nga. Oo nga. Anong gagawin natin? Nag-respond po sila. Alam mo na maalisin natin. Oo. Nag-respond po sila. Opo. So yun ang gagawin ba? And then, whenever possible, ladies and gentlemen, we reproduce some kind of a PDF format. For example, this is for Antipolo. Yan. So you could check who responded or not, right? Awesome. Yan siya. We have about 500 for Antipolo. Okay? The variables are age, sex, civil status, education, attainment, life in church, and ex-diocese. Then, you're telling me, oh, there are some who are missing us, so you have to tell us so you could, we could send you. But what is important here is this. I'm going to close this off. What is important is this. We also provided everyone a Excel file. Kasi, you cannot edit it or what if it's a PDF, right? Now, there's an Excel file. That is the work of research. You could actually document, and you should be documenting in beautiful forms your catechist, right? Isn't that fascinating? So you will be given that that demographics, although limited po. Now, when it comes to, so that's the first one. The other one is the ET raw frequencies. Yan. We have raw frequencies for all those who responded to us. Raw frequencies, ibig sabihin, yung mga descriptives generated from SPSS. Who do you want to see? Let's say, Kalibo? Kalibo.